everyone. Before we begin our course, I wanted to do a quick video on the different movements of the body, as well as the names of the body and the joints, just so you guys have a good overall view before doing the classes. Okay, so let's start at the top and work our way down. So the first one is the neck. Let's begin with flexion, dropping chin to chest, and extension. Then look at rotation to the right and rotation to the left. So with the glenohumeral joint, we have internal rotation and external rotation. We then have extension of the glenohumeral joint and flexion. We can also look at internal rotation when the thumb goes behind you, and external rotation, the thumb comes to the front. And you can take it quite far, depending on where you're at. Same thing here, so internal rotation would be taking the thumb to the front of the room, external rotation, taking the thumb back behind you and maybe a little bit further. So the scapula, we have elevation, actively lifting the shoulders up, depression, actively drawing the shoulders down. We then have protraction, drawing the shoulders forward, and then retraction, squeezing the shoulder blades towards each other. So with the elbow, we've got extension and flexion. With that, we also have this movement of supination and pronation in flexion and extension. So this is pronation, and then supination in extension. Let's have a look at the wrist. So with the wrist, we've got flexion and extension, and then we have internal rotation and external rotation. Let's move on to the rest of the spine. So we know that segmental cat-cows are really great to do for the spine. So you really want to move from the coccyx all the way up the lower back, through the thoracic spine, into the cervical spine. So we can just practice a few just to see how it goes. Really moving slowly, starting from the coccyx again. And this would be flexion of the spine, so let's take a look at the hips. I like to do this one standing because it gives you more of an idea. So we have flexion, externally rotation, and internal rotation, lifting the foot up as high as you can, taking it back into extension. So extension, internal rotation, dropping the foot down, external rotation, coming into flexion. So with the knee, we have flexion and extension. In flexion, we can have internal rotation, so just the tibia is moving, and external rotation. In extension, the same thing, internal rotation and external. With extension, we like to have a slight bend in the knee, and that'll help to get more movement in the tibia rather than starting to go into the femur. Then we also have the foot, which is plantar flexion, dorsiflexion, and then eversion and inversion. Review this video and just have a look just to make sure that you understand all the names, and then I'll see you in the next video.